guys did to earn what you guys got here, this legend status?
AV honor roll?
AV honor roll? So great.
I know.
You don't know? Well, maybe it's because you raised your hand before you spoke, and that means you're polite. How about that? Maybe you were really nice to somebody, and that's what you got the award for. But isn't that cool, guys, that you guys earned this? You guys earned it in your seats, right? So you guys get Thanksgiving dinner for your family. That's awesome. That's a great accomplishment. I'm proud of you guys. But we just wanted to get up here to reiterate what they were saying on the video, and that you know, how important it is to treat others, you know, kindly, to be respectful, to stand out, basically, in a world today that doesn't have too many people doing the right thing too often. So, you know, it's always good to help other people, to be respectful, listen to your teachers, you know, do good in school. AV Honor Roll is awesome. I mean, just keep all that up and just keep doing what you guys are doing. Apparently you guys are on the right track. That's why you're chosen for the award. So,
like I said in the video, welcome to the club.
Yeah.
Right? Good job, guys. So, at the end of the day, I feel like you said, and like the video says, you got to respect your teachers, your parents, each other. It sounds as though a lot of you are making good decisions and have obviously done the right thing in the situations that you have been put in. And like they said up there too, you're going to run into hard times, you're going to have decisions to make throughout your life, and ultimately you have to take a step back and say, okay, you know, based on this decision I make, where am I going to end up from it? You know what I mean? So it sounds as though at this point in time, you're all making the right decisions and putting yourselves in good situations, and look at the outcome. See what I mean? You get put in a good, you know, yeah, definitely. You get rewarded. You. Parents, teachers, everybody's proud of you for what you've done, and in turn, you're in the Legends Club, right? Pretty big deal, I feel like.
Yeah, that's awesome.
So all you can do is keep working, keep getting better, and you know, luckily for us, we've been able to make a little bit of a name for ourselves in baseball. But all sports, even just being in clubs at school, anything, any situation, any opportunity you have, based on if you put yourself around the right people, make the right decisions, can positively influence yourself and others around you. Right? So with that being said, every chance you get to be, you know, to be around somebody, have a positive influence, love them, care for them, treat them right, you know, respect people, respect yourselves. All these are good opportunities to go out there and have a positive influence on everyone around you. And so it sounds as though to me, you're doing the right thing at this point, and you started off on the right foot. So,
and this world, you know, it's tough. You know, how many people think life's easy? Super easy. Couple of you. All right. Well, I mean, you'll learn here that the way you treat people and stuff has a direct effect on what kind of life you can have. And so, you know, like he was saying, we were saying, and the video was saying, it sounds like you guys are on the right track. Just keep it up. And if you guys can do this, I know you probably have questions. Anybody have questions? No? Maybe? All right. If we have questions, we can do questions.
We got a question.
Well, maybe not.
Anything about baseball, about life, about anything about them that you'd like to know, Cynthia?
What about friends get us off track?
Good question.
Sometimes you get off track, but it's always important to ask other people that you have in your family that are older and try and figure out what's right to do in certain situations.
Communicate, you know what I mean? I think that's big in today's time. Not a whole lot of people communicate with each other.
Yeah.
You know, if they have those questions, well, talk to them, talk it out, and you know, give them some options. You know what I mean? And hopefully they'll do the same for you if you ever come into a problem or a situation that you might need some outside advice. And, you know, come together, put your heads together, make a good decision. That's awesome.
Yeah.
Good job.
Angelina, your question.
That's right. Yeah, that's right. You're not going to win every time, and that's life. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
In sports. And
yeah. In baseball, you know, we fail a lot. Like, the Hall of Famers are hitting 375. That means they're failing 75% of the time. And what we realized through baseball and all that is it's not how much you fail, it's how you fail. So if you can fail and be positive about it, learn from it, That's the most important thing.
Yeah.
Because we fail all the time, but what we're doing is we're trying not to. You know what I'm saying? We just don't accept the failure. We try and better ourselves.
I don't know if you've ever seen the movie Meet the Robinsons. Anybody ever seen that? Yeah, right? They fail all the time. They almost congratulate each other on failure, right? Because it helps you to learn and to do better next time, right? So failure is not always a bad thing. All right, take that as a positive. Learn from it and better yourself from it in the future.
Clinton, your question.
Good listening.
We both hit 99.
Yeah, he's hit a few more times than me. I got it once in my life.
It didn't help.
I ain't got it in there no more, though.
Xavier, do you have a question?
James.
Have y'all hit a home run?
You hit one in Triple A. Oh. I've hit a home run in Triple A, well, professional baseball, not in the big leagues, though.
I only got one at bat in the big leagues.
And most pitchers, that's their profession, and so a lot of them aren't batters as well. They're
unless
in a lot
in
of
the
as a pitcher.
National League,
I gave up a bunch of home runs if that counts. I'm gonna get them hit out on me.
Yeah, definitely gave up a bunch. You have a question?
You're just stretching.
No, just stretching.
I think they're being shadows on it. Right here, your question.
Football's good. Football's good. I played football in high school. I actually was going to go to Penn State. You guys know where Penn State is, or are you guys all Alabama and Auburn down here?
Now they wake up.
A few Georgia sprinkles in there. Oh,
Houston.
Any questions? Anybody have any questions?
Got one right here. Got you.
My brother got hurt by football.
Did he? Well, sometimes you gotta make sure you put your hands in front of the ball and let it hit you in the face.
Yeah.
Oh, that's
tough.
Did he tackle him?
Yeah. That's the name of the game.
Yep.
You gotta be slippery, you gotta be strong.
Zad, do you have a question? No, we're just trying to. All right, question right there.
Either of you had a sports injury that keep you out of the game? And if so, tell me about recovery to get back in.
I think you're talking to two guys who have a lot of experience, right?
Yeah, so that's one of the things about like failing is also like, sometimes you have complications that come up that you can't control. Like I had Tommy John in 2007, and my elbow basically blew out. And I guess 85% of the time you can return to where you were or better after the surgery, and it took me a year to rehab from it, but it's like one of those things, guys, you can't give up, you know what I mean? If you know that you're doing something that's positive and stuff, don't ever give up. Don't let people discourage you. Don't ever give up on yourself.
And I use that to apply that to school. You know, I mean, sometimes you go in there, maybe you're not as prepared for a test as you wanted to be or whatever, or something pops up and you go in there, and we all have done it to where, you know, it's test day, you go in there, you know the information back and forth, next thing you know, you forget it. You go that you draw a blank and you forget, you may make a bad grade, but the next time, it's okay. Go into the next test and study up a little bit harder and you make the good grade and come out on top. So it's, I feel injuries, you know, everything in life. Once again, I know we've said about four or five times now, but everything in life, you're going to have struggles. You're going to have down times. You're going to have really good times as well. But always take every situation and use it to better yourself and those around you.
To put it in like perspective, so I was still playing baseball, and I broke my leg 2 years ago. And so I've had 13 surgeries in the last 2 years on my left leg, and I just got cleared to be able to start throwing and all that stuff again. So I'm gonna actually try and get back again. But I'll show you my leg, it's pretty ugly. I'm not gonna be a leg model anymore, but I wear a sock up over it to compress it. But I had all pins, ready to cut an inch of bone out of here, and I stretched this bone down an inch, but I didn't give up. I wanted to a lot of times, but it's one of those things where you gotta realize that life is more than just about yourself, and you have to
help others also.
All right, we have time for one more question before we need to do your stuff. I'm going to let you.
Play a little bit everywhere.
Well, you
that's a good player.
Yeah.
Keep your options open.
All right. Now I'm gonna play
football. Nice. Yeah. Very good.
All right,
very
boys
cool.
And girls, we're going to give out your certificates at this time and your packets. Now, some of your parents are here, so we'll let you, when it's over, take that to them. If not, then we'll Miss Lane and I'll talk to you about how to get that home today. Okay. All right.